Hallelujah! Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Hello, boys and girls. I am so glad that you were able to join me for a Sunday school lesson today. It's Miss Belinda. I am here in the 4th to 6th grade classroom at St. Thomas' Episcopal Church in Newark, Delaware. Let's get started. The Lord be with you. And also with you. We gather in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Easter was many Sundays ago. Easter season is 50 days long, and today is that 50th day. It's the day of Pentecost. So, I have a special story just for Pentecost, and I have my Pentecost shirt, as you can see. I'm all ready. So, let's get started. Let's see our getting ready song. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Remember that when we sing that song, our eyes should be watching, our ears should be listening, hands and feet are tucked in close so that we are ready. So, I have this box today for our story. And it is a red box. Reminds me of a parable. But I know it can't be a parable because it's red. So, I wonder what it is. I guess it could be like a parable, but not quite a parable. I bet that's what it is. Let me look inside and see what's in there. Some other things in there, but nothing else to help us get ready. So let's just get started. There was once a great tower. Everyone working on the tower spoke the same language and worked together. But as the tower got taller and taller, they began to talk in different ways. The tower came closer and closer to God, but the people forgot why they were building it. They grew so proud of themselves that they began to believe that they were greater builders than God. Each group thought it was better than any of the others. A huge noise replaced their talking. It made no sense. Everyone was babbling. Soon, the tower fell down. So it was called the Tower of Babel. The language of the people of the earth was shattered and broke into splinters. Each one was beautiful, but it was broken. thousands of years passed. Then Jesus died on the cross. But somehow he was still with the people around him, just like he is with us. They kept seeing him, and they couldn't let him go. Then something amazing happened. The disciples were in Jerusalem. Here they are. Peter, James, John, Andrew, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James the Less, Simon, and Jude. There were only 11 disciples at this time because Judas had already died. Jesus took them outside Jerusalem to a mountain called Olivet, or as far as Bethany. Jesus then went up, and soon the Holy Spirit came down. The 11 disciples went back to Jerusalem. They were so full of joy. They went to the temple to pray. gathered again in the upper room. And with God's help, they decided that Matthias would take Judas' place. On Sunday, the 12 were together again. Suddenly, there was a sound like a mighty wind rushing in to be with them. It was the Holy Spirit. They became so full of power that they seemed to be on fire. Their tongues burned inside their mouths. They were so excited that people wondered what was going on. When the disciples went out into the street, there were people there from many different countries. They spoke many different languages. Everyone could see that the 12 had come close to God, and God had come close to them. In a new way, it no longer mattered that they spoke different languages. The disciples had become apostles. They went out into the world to tell this story. Ever since, Pentecost has been celebrated to remember that day. Now, I wonder, what part of the story you liked best? I wonder what part of the story was the most important. I wonder where you are in the story. I wonder if you've ever come close to something like this. All right, boys and girls, I'm going to put away the story pieces because I have something else to show you. Do art response at this time, but we can't because I'm here and you're there. But I know that you and your family are doing some cool things at home, and I know that you'll find some other cool things to do to respond to the story. I wanted to show you what I did this week. So Some of you did it also, I know, because you showed me. But here's my windsock that I made for Pentecost. I can hang it up. And it has a dove on it, which is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. It has some fire. It has more fire hanging down. And it's a windsock, so it blows in the wind, just like that rushing wind that came in when the disciples were in the upper room. The other thing that I made that you can make at home are these streamers that I know some of you made. You can wave these during a Pentecost parade or a celebration. And say, Happy Pentecost with you and your family. You could run around the yard with them, whatever you want to do with them. Have fun. All right, I'm going to put these away because it is time for us to pray. First thing we're going to pray is the Children's Creed. I believe in God above, I believe in Jesus' love, I believe His Spirit too, comes to show us what to do. I believe I can be kind and loving, Lord, like Thee. Right, now let's say the Lord's Prayer. That's the one that we say usually upstairs with our grown-ups. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And then the last kind of prayer that we always do is our own personal prayers. This is a time when we can thank God for something or someone. We can tell God what we're worried about or what we're sad about. We might want to pray for something that we need or someone else needs. Whatever you need to say to God, you can do that in prayer. Okay, so I will start and then I'll give you a turn. Let us pray. Lord, I thank you today for this beautiful day. I thank you for my family. I thank you for my church family, especially the children and the families of St. Thomas's Children's Ministry. I thank you for my friends who helped me lead children's ministry. I thank you for my friends who have done it over the years, but are doing other things now, like choir, and Altar Guild, and all those wonderful things that St. Thomas does. Thank you, Lord, for giving us all an opportunity to serve in our own special way. I thank you, Lord, for the blessings that you've given us, especially enough food to eat and clean water to drink and houses to live in where we can be safe. We thank you especially, Lord, for sending the Holy Spirit down to be with us, to comfort us, to sustain us, to help us to be brave when things are hard. Amen. All right, it's your turn to tell someone close to you what you'd like to pray for today. Lord, we thank you for hearing all of our prayers today and for always being with us. then. So, it is time to say goodbye. So, we're going to change the light one last time. Change the light so that the light that's in one place will be in all places all around us. Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere.